Hi, welcome to Fixed by Doc, and today we're talking homemade fishing poles. Yay! And I hope you can see this, but the pieces you're going to need is a good stick, brightly green so that it can flex without breaking. It needs to be about approximately 3 feet for a small pole. You're not going to make a really big pole with this. You're going to need 4 of these eye hook screws. They got to be the eye loops, not the hooks, actually. You need 1 or 2 of these Ranger bands or any kind of strong rubber band. And you're going to need a little stick like this, approximately 6 inches long, 6 to 8 inches long. This stick preferably needs to have a slight curve to it, like an S shape, and so that when it sits on this stick, it will point up like that. The reason for that is this stick here is what you're going to run your fishing line. You're going to wrap your fishing line all around this. You're also going to put a split right here. Now what I've done with these two sticks is I've cut a flat piece right here, so this is nice and flat, and I've done the same thing with this one. This is nice and flat. So when they sit on here, it makes a nice flat surface holding this up. You need to measure the spot for that flat surface. You're going to find out how much of the stick you need to hold in your fist. And you want like another inch or inch and a half sticking out from the bottom of your fist. Then you're going to place this one over, and you want to be able to hold it like this so that the point where it starts to stick out from the other stick, your finger is going to be right about there. Okay. Once you have that there, you would take your Ranger band here, and you would wrap your Ranger band on right around that to hold that in place. With the eyelets, you're going to screw one eyelet into the end here. First find out the natural bend of it, and then you're going so that you know which side's the top and bottom. Then you're going to put the eyelet here in the end of the stick, and then across the top of the bend, you're going to put it about 4 to 5 inches away, another eyelet here, and then about 8 to 10 inches down, put another one in, your third one, and then 8 to 10 inches further, put your fourth one in. So once you've done that, and you've got your spool stick and everything all carved and ready to go, then you'll wrap your fishing line around this and get it set. Then you'll attach the Ranger band onto it, and once you've got that set, you'll run it through your loops here. And at that point, you'll almost be ready to go fishing. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the camera off right now and add the fishing line to this and completely assemble it. One other thing I've done real quick is I shaved off all the bark. That's optional. Personally, I'd like to have this stick around for a little while. So if you leave bark on the sticks, it usually causes the stick to decay and get old really fast. But by removing the bark, you increase the longevity of the stick, and you get to use it longer. So, alright, I'm going to go ahead and shut this off and finish making a stick, and then I'll turn it right back on. Okay, now I've got my fishing line spooled on here. What I did is I drilled a little hole in this stick so that I can run the fishing line through the spool stick and tie it off. And I put a little notch on this end so that after I spool it up, I can pull it over the notch here, and it holds it in place. Then I ran line through all these little hooks, eye loops, and then I attached my bobber. I attached my, I forgot what these pieces are called here, but it's a little wire thing that ties to your fishing line, allows you to quick release your bait. And then I put on, right now I got a little fish on there, but I would you can put on a hook and put on whatever bait you want. And so there's your fishing pole right there. To cast this, you would just hold it like this. You would unhook it from the end. And now your thumb here should be, you've unhooked the fishing line here, so now your thumb is putting pressure on the line so it doesn't unspool. Then hopefully you can see it cast, hit the ground over there. So there you go. And hopefully that got on there. If not, you've all seen fishing lines cast before. It's pretty much the same thing. Now to reel it in, you take your stick and you pull it sideways like this. Put your hand up here wrap your hand around, put your thumb over it, and now you're just waiting for a fish to bite. And then once the fish bites, or you need to check your bait, you're just reeling it around the stick. Make sure you zigzag the line up and down the spool so that it doesn't get tangled up or anything. Because if you just wrap it up around the end here, just around the end, then when it'll all come off at once and it'll get all tangled up. So you need to wrap it up and down the stick. And it takes a little while to wind it up if you cast it out really far, because you're not using a traditional handle or anything like that that you'd have on a fishing pole allows you to reel it in real fast. The bigger your spool stick is in diameter, the less amount of time it'll take you to rewind it. But this is made for, not for like deep sea fishing or anything like that. This is good for like streams, creeks, and river fishing and stuff like that. And for fish, I'd say under 5 or 10 pounds. And there we have it. It's all back up. Now that I've got it back, I'm going to take it, hold the fishing line right here, put it through my little notch right there so it doesn't unwind. Now I'm going to let go of it. I'm going to take my fish, and I would, if I had a fish on there, and take it, pull my fish off, pop them in my bait bucket, and be good and done. So there you have it, the homemade fishing pole, using just a pocket knife, a couple of sticks, and everything that you see in here. Now there's not this really nice, where is he? Right there. I don't have this really nice fish, rubber fish lure or this bobber inside this kit, but to make a bobber you just use another piece of stick, and you can either drill a hole through it if you want to tie it on, or you can just tie the line to the stick. You don't have to get anything fancy or nothing. But you use another piece of stick as a float bobber, and then any grubs or worms you dig up as bait. And I have some of those flat shiny discs in here that you could add to the hook area to use as spinners to attract the fish. And I got some non-lead weights in here. Leaded weights aren't allowed up here in Michigan. In here is 4 eye hooks and to make the fishing pole with, or you could stick them in a log that's stretched out across the river or whatever, and put your fishing line through it, add your hook and your baited hook and stuff, and then on the other end you tie it to a key ring that can't fit through there, like these two little key rings I have in here. Tie your fishing line to that, and then basically when a fish grabs it and attaches, you know, you bait a fish, then you just pull on the key ring and pull your line up, take your fish off, rebait it, and drop it back down in. And you're good to go. You put this kit right here, it's got me set up for putting 4 of those out or making 1 fishing pole. I have room in here, I could probably put in 4 more hooks, which I think I'll do. 4 more eyelets, so that I could have 4 bait line and 1 fishing pole going on. And this case right here is just a the SD card for your digital cameras. That's what's in this case. Some other real things real quick here, if I got enough time. 5 minutes? Yeah, I think I'm good. You can use some heavier line for your bank line if you want. You can also use some sinew. This is imitation sinew, which is really strong. You can use that for your bank line or whatever. And so here's the fishing pole. Hope you like it. As soon as I get a fishing license, I will go out to the lake and I'll show it to you in action. So thanks for watching FixedByDoc, and have a good day.